Hello everyone! This time I'm not going to make resin geode coasters, but I'm going to create a resin geode tray again. And again I'm going to use the puddle technique, but this time in a different way. I'm also using a new resin that Resin Pro sent me, so I'm very curious how it works. So for the new people to my channel that like resin tutorials like this one, or tutorials of acrylics, alcohol ink, and a lot of other tutorials, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because then you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So I'm going to create a resin geode tray again, and I'm also going to use some of my own natural mica pigments. The first color is one of my own. It's the sequoia color. Nice brown color with a copper sheen. So very nice on the edge. Next to it, again, a color of my own, and this is the sangria. Very nice deep red color, and I let them bleed into each other because I like that. I don't like straight lines, so that's why I'm pouring it straight next to it, so that they can blend into each other. So the first color I've used, the brown color with a copper sheen, is a sequoia. And this color is the sangria. For the people that are interested in my own natural mica pigments from my pigment line Just Paint, they are available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. She has listed them in her Etsy shop. The link to her Etsy shop is in the description box. She also has some nice discounts and free shipping above $30. For the other countries, I've also listed them in my Etsy shop. So they are available worldwide. So if you're curious, please check out the description box. And what I mentioned, I'm using a new resin that Resin Pro sent me. And it's a food safe resin. But we all know if we add colorants into the resin, then it's not food safe anymore. But yeah, I want to have color, because I want to create a nice colorful geode tray. So what I will be doing is that when I finish the tray, I will be adding a clear layer of that food safe resin. So then it's all okay. But the consistency is the same as the Resin Pro, Art Pro, what I normally use, a resin. So that's good, because I don't like a thin resin. I want it a little bit thicker. So in the middle I've added some nice natural mica flakes in the color copper. And I also mix some gold leaf into it. And now I'm pouring some clear resin on top of it. So again, I'm using a food safe resin, and because I mixed pigments in it, then it's not food safe anymore. So that's why I'm going to add on the top and the bottom a clear layer of this resin. So the next color is alcohol ink, and it's the Baya Blue. I mix a few drops into my resin. And I'm going to fill it, the whole layer, with this color. Again, some clear on top of my mica flakes and my gold leaf. So this tray will be getting three layers. Because of the clear layers I will be adding. No, two layers. Because I want to add a clear layer on the top side, but I also need to add a clear layer on the back side, and then it's totally food safe. I will be adding the link to that resin in the description box. So if you want to check it out, the link is in the description box. And also don't forget, I still have a promo code of the Resin Pro company. If you use my code Petra on the German side or the UK side, then you get 10% discount on your total value order. So that's great. Using the heat gun to remove some air bubbles. And now I'm adding a line of the Cool Mint from Lures. And what I mentioned, I'm going to use the puddle technique, but then in a different way. Normally you pour the puddles on top of each other, but now I'm going to do it in lines. So first the Cool Mint, and on top of it the Casting Craft White. Also a line on top of the Cool Mint. And on top of the white, I'm adding clear resin. So I normally use this technique for my geode coasters. Then I pour puddles on top of each other in the same order. But now I'm doing it in lines. And then see what I get. The heat gun to remove again some air bubbles. And also the silicon geode tray mold is from Molds and Shapes. It's a Dutch company, but they ship worldwide. So if you're interested in this mold, I will add a link to their Facebook page in the description box. The only thing you need to do is send them a message through that Facebook page, and then it will all be okay. But this is a very nice silicon mold, and it fits perfectly with the geode coasters, and it's the same quality. So if you are interested, all the information is in the description box. Now with a stick, I'm dragging the Cool Mint and the white to the middle. And then I'm creating a nice pattern. Hopefully I will also get a nice design on the back of this tray. Because what I also want with my geode coasters, I want to use it on both sides. That's my goal. Again, the heat gun to remove some air bubbles, and then I'm done with this layer. Need to let it dry before I can work on it again. Yeah, I'm going to add some gold leaf, but also some super shard glass glitter. But I'm starting with the gold leaf, so in some areas I want to add the gold leaf, but first I need to use the gold leaf glue. It's specially made to stick the gold leaf to any surface that you want to stick it to. So in this case I'm going to add it to my resin. There you can see it. I'm adding the gold leaf on top of the glue. It's So I'm not going to show you the whole process, only parts of it, because this is very time consuming. Again, I'm adding the glue in some places. And I must say the resin dried very well. It's very shiny. So that's good. Adding more of the gold leaf. So we are a little bit further in the process. So I'm just laying those gold leaf parts on top of the glue, and later I will be brushing away with a soft brush the excess. And I never throw anything away, but I don't think I have a lot of excess. But normally if I have parts, I keep it, and then I can use it in other projects. There, you can see it with the brush. I'm brushing the excess. So where there is no glue, they will not, the gold leaf will not stick. And then those parts I will be brushing away. There you can see it. Again, a little bit further in the process, adding the glue again. And then I'm using my heat gun to dry the glue. Because the glue needs to be dry before you can add your gold leaf on top of it. There you can see it. Pressing it down with my fingers. Again, I'm using my heat gun to dry it. And I'm using my brush to brush away the excess that I can see. So all the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites as I always do. So if you want to see what I used, then it's in the description box. Now I'm using a paper towel, a dry paper towel, to remove the small parts of gold leaf very carefully. And now I will be adding some super shard glass glitter in the color gold. And in the, some places I will be adding this, and then later on I will pour on top of the gold leaf and the glass glitter. But I want to see if it looks nice. That's why I'm adding the glass glitter now. You can also add it in your wet resin, but I'm doing it now because then I can see much better if it's nice or not. Because it needs a little bit of sparkle. You all know I love sparkle. So at the end of this video I will be showing you a close-up in the daylight, in the sun, from the front and also the back. Hopefully the backside is also nice. Also in the middle some glass glitter. Yeah, and I'm moving those pieces of glitter around to see how it looks and if I like it or not. So now I'm going to add a clear layer of resin, what I already mentioned in the beginning, because this is the same resin, the food safe resin. It's a new resin from Resin Pro, and because I want to have it food safe, so the top will get a clear layer, but also the back. And very carefully I pour the resin on top of my glass glitter. And I always start in the middle and I work my way to the outside. There you can see it. Yeah, and I'm liking this so far. I have some nice effects in the middle with the cool mint and the white, and also the design I like a lot. Hopefully the bag is nice. But yeah, we need to wait for that. So I'm almost done with the clear layer. So the heat gun to remove some air bubbles. Then I need to let this dry for 24 hours and then I can take it out of the mold. So we are 24 hours later and now I can take it out of the mold. It's dry and it dried very well, so hopefully it will get comes out very easy out of the mold, and so you can see no problems there. It's very shiny. There you can see it. And now the backside. How does the backside look? And this is the backside. Yeah, there is a lot of depth. You can't see it that well. I like those colors together. At the end, I will show you a close-up. And then you can see the effects much better. There you can see the gold leaf and the glass glitter. Nice design. And now the back side. Hopefully you can see the depth. I like it. And it does work also with pouring lines. Not only puddles, but lines also. So that's great. So this is a close-up of the front side in the daylight, in the sun. So yeah, I like the glass glitter and the gold leaf. But yeah, I can imagine that some people find it a little bit too busy. And the colors are great, the sequoia and the sangria, but together with the cool mint. I like that a lot. The nice design in the middle. Now you can see it a little bit closer. Yeah, I think it's nice. Sparkles a lot. Yeah, and this is the same side, the front side, but now with sunlight behind it, so that you can see that the middle part is transparent. I like that a lot, because I used the alcohol ink and I made it very transparent. There you can see the design. Very nice. And this is a close-up of the back side. It's not that busy as the front. It has a lot of depth. I like those colors together. Very nice. So let me know what you think of this geode tray. If you like the front or the back or both or none. It's also possible. I try to show you the depth. And this side, I also added a clear layer of resin. So it's now totally food safe. the natural mica flakes and the gold leaf together with the super sharp glass glitter. Very nice. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up for this video if you like it. I would appreciate it a lot. And all the information about the websites, Facebook, Instagram, you name it, my natural mica pigment line is in the description box. And also my influencers Amazon store. I want to thank you all for watching again. And hopefully I will see you all in the next video. Bye.